And wellity wellity, welcome folks, welcome to another part of Resident Evil. Last time we left off, we killed a bunch of tentacle monsters, we put a blue eye into a stone tiger, and we are now continuing on with the rest of the game, because why not? Okay, so next part we want to go into this room. You have used the lockpick. Yes, we have. So let's see what we can get into in terms of... hijinks in here! Will you take the clip? Yes, we will, because we really need more bullets. Okay, so now we have... ooh, a book! Just better check what's in here. Can't check what's in them, alright. Probably nothing. What's in here then? Nice stuff on the desk. Oh, no, my god, it's a zombie! Shoot him! Shoot! Okay, he's down. One more bullet. Oh, no. Two more bullets. Okay, two more bullets. And who was this he gave us? Will you take the shells? Yes, we will. Woohoo, we got shotgun shells. Thank you, Mr. Zombie. Keeper's Diary. May 9th, 1998. At night, we played poker with Scott the Guard, Alias? No idea. And Steve the Researcher. Steve was really lucky, but I think he was cheating. What a scumbag. Yeah, screw Steve. I'm talking to you, Steve. Yeah, I can tell you're watching. God. May 10th, 1998. Today, a high-ranking researcher asked me to take care of a new monster. It looked like a gorilla without any skin. They told me to feed them live food. When I threw in a pig, they were playing with it, tearing off the pig's legs and pulling up the guts before they actually ate it. Sounds like me at a carvery. May 11th, 1998. Around 5 o'clock this morning, Scott came in and woke me up suddenly. Yeah, I have a tendency to do that. He was wearing a protection suit that looked like a spacesuit. He told me to put one on as well. I heard there was an accident in the basement lab. It's no wonder those researchers never rest, even at night. So they're vampires? May 12th, 1998. I've been wearing this annoying spacesuit since yesterday. My skin grows musty, feels very itchy. By way of revenge, I didn't feed those dogs today. Now I feel better. What did the dogs do to you? It's not the dog's fault you have to wear a spacesuit. May 13th, 1998. I went to the medical room because my back is all swollen and feels itchy. They put a big bandage on my back and the doctor told me I did not need to wear the spacesuit anymore. I guess I can sleep well tonight. Well, you've got a massive bandage on your back, so you tell me. May 14th, 1998. I woke up this morning. I found another blister on my foot. It was annoying, and I ended up dragging my foot as I went to the dog's pen. They had been quiet since this morning, which was very unusual. I found out that some of them had escaped. I'll be in real trouble if the high-ups found out. So those are the dogs we ran into at the very beginning. May 15th, 1998. Even though I didn't feel well, I decided to go and see Nancy. It's my first day off in a long time, but I was stopped by a guard on the way out. They said the company has ordered... They ordered that no one leave the grounds. I can't even make a phone call. What kind of joke is this? ! See what kind of joke it is? A bad one. May 16th, 1998. I heard a researcher who tried to escape from this mansion was shot last night. My entire body feels burning and itchy at night. When I was scratching the swelling on my arm, a lump of rotten flesh fell off. What the hell is happening to me? Sounds like you're dying, mate. May 19th, 1998. Fever gone, but itchy. Hungry and eat doggy food. Itchy, itchy Scott came. Ugly face, so killed him. Tasty. Hate it when I get killed. 4. Itchy. Tasty. Very itchy. Itchy, tasty, indeed. Mr. Keeper. So his diary has been filed, and I'm assuming he just came out of the closet there. Ba-dum-ts. So let's see what else we can do now we have our fancy new key. So the main goal that we have is that we want to find the, whatchamacallit, the four crests, which are very important because, after all, in a game where you have to collect things, crests are very important. So what we're going to do is, we're going to take this emblem, because why not, and we're going to be doing a very famous puzzle with it, because we're going to go back. And we're going to go to the door at the very end of the hallway. Because now we can open it, I believe. So up we run. You have used the lockpick. In we go. Ooh, it's a very fancy door. Well, that's kind of door I'd want. And we have what looks to be a bar. Very nice. So anyway, so let's push this out of the way, and we find ourselves some sheet music. We take the music notes, well, call it whatever you want, and we, for no reason whatsoever, decide we're going to play a little piano. So let's use the music notes. It's Moonlight Sonata, a personal favourite piece of mine, actually. Thanks to this game. Didn't know you needed to play the piano to get onto the police squad. Just saying. Very lovely. And it does in fact have a point because it opens the door! Cue the Legend of Zelda sound, which I will not, because I'll probably get flagged for fair use, knowing how that's going on at the moment. Look, can we stick... Look, our gun sticks out of the window. Anyway, so we're going to take this gold emblem. Very shiny, and looks exactly the same as the other emblem. And oh no, we're locked in! Oh my god, what are we going to do? I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to replace it with the wooden emblem. And that opens the door back up for us. Yay. Okay, so let us head on back to the main dining room again. So we can put the gold emblem in and see what we can find. Who knows? Maybe it'll give us some kind of magical prize, like a harpoon gun, so we can harpoon zombies. Maybe it will activate the Lara Croft mode. Then we can have two heads and run around with Uzis. Okay, so let's put in the gold emblem and... dong! The clock strikes three. And moves out of the way for us to reveal a safe. So let's see what's inside this safe. Hopefully something that actually needed worth... that's worth protecting. It is... where you take the mansion key. No, so we got another key. Let's see what this one is. It is, in fact, a carving of a shield. So we got a shield key. Very useful indeed, I imagine. So we're going to go back up here. And there's, in fact, two rooms that we want to check out. That are both upstairs. One of them is all the way back in the staircase where we shot those two zombies. You know, where the save room is. And the other one is right next to the doorway. But we're going to be going for the one at the other end where the staircase is first, because why not? So let's run. Whoa! Thought I killed you. Okay, back up. Run, 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 run. There we go. Dodge like a boss. Okay, so there's no zombie there. Matchy jump while we're at it. We're just going to go in here and use our armor key. Today we're multitasking, layers upon layers of what we're planning on doing. And we've got a puzzle room. What we want to do is go push these two statues over these vents. If you do not, then bad things will happen. Fun fact, there are, this is actually a upgraded puzzle in the DS version of this game, which I highly recommend if you can find it. Because in the DS version, you get touchscreen puzzles, and there's actually a set of scales there instead of the statues. And you have to, like, weigh out gems in order to get the door open. It's quite a fun puzzle. There's a switch. Will you push it? Yes, we will. And because we covered over the vents, we are allowed to gather our prize. Which is... Will you take the sun crest? Yes, we will. So now we've got two crests. So we're halfway there. Because whoever does puzzles in threes... Twos, maybe. Fives, even possibly. But threes? That's just crazy. I doubt we're going to see a puzzle of three in this game, that's for sure. Okay, so we cleared out this hallway because we are awesome in every conceivable way. Just going to run downstairs and dump some items. Because we don't need to carry these crests around for a while. And just going to run into Ja. And what do we find? Tell me and see. We found a combat knife, a bazooka, acid rounds, and nothing else. That is the joke. Okay, so all those are gone. We'll keep everything else. Okay, next up we need to run upstairs again and go to one of the doors that we didn't go head into. Because there's another important item that we need. And it's all the way up here. And I just hit the wire. You probably heard that, and now you're judging me because of my amateur filming and recording setup. Don't judge me, I'm not rich. You have used the armor key. Yes, we have. So let's see what we can dig up in here. First off, let's have a look in this room. And we find beds! Ah! And a very important item, the one we came up here for. Will you take the lighter? Yes, we will. So we got ourselves a lighter, and if I'm right, there's a red herb. So we can mix that with our other herb. So take that. And we can mix those two herbs together and do magical things with it. So mix the herbs, that frees up another space. And now we go into the room on the other side. See what's in there. I'm sure it's something completely safe, nothing dangerous whatsoever. Hello, Moose. Or Deer. Whichever you prefer to be called. Ooh, looks like we've got a science room. And there's a fish tank. And some shattered glass. I wonder what's in the shattered glass. It seems someone has searched here already. It appears to be a switch. Will you push it? I just say that's very strong glass if it just shatters in that one key area. Okay, so that drains somehow. And now we can slip in here and push this out of the way. Heave! Heave again. And ooh, some little doors. Will you take the explosive rounds? Yes, we will. That's the whole point of coming in here. But actually, no, there's one more thing we can do, and that's right here. Researchers will. My dear Alma, the fact you have received this letter is both a joy and a sadness for me. I could not even talk to you because of that guy in the sunglasses. Wonder who that could be. Alma, be calm and read this. I think I've told you that I moved to a pharmaceutical company's lab. They headhunted me. Last month there was an accident in the lab, and the virus we were studying escaped. All of my colleagues who were affected by the virus are now dead. To be accurate, they became the living dead. They still wander around. Some of them are knocking on my room door desperately right now, but there's no sign of intelligence in their eyes. That cursed virus takes away all humanity from the human brain. Love, joy, sorrow, fear, humor. Eventually. I mean, eternally. I can't read. And Alma, even the memories of the days I spent with you. Yes, I'm infected. I did everything I could, but I could only delay the progress by a few days. The most frightening thing is that I forget more about you by the day. I choose a peaceful death rather than becoming the living dead. Within the hour, I will have entered my eternal sleep. I hope you will understand my decision. Goodbye, and forever yours, Michael Crackhorn. R.I.P. Michael Crackhorn. Which kind of makes no sense, seeing as he said he read the letter, and how was he going to send off the letter if everyone in the house was dead in the hour? And he'd be dead in the hour, and I sure as heck don't believe that the mailman or the postal service is going to be collecting from here. And he doesn't look the sort to be able to run out of here, get into the post office, send the letter, and then run back, and then kill himself. So I'm just confused as to what his plan was going to be for sending that letter. So we're just going to go in here, and we find, ooh, a fireplace with a picture. And wood is put in the stove. A paper is on the wall. Well, this is why we need the lighter, because we light the fire. And just like when you dry those messages with lemon on them, we get a map. Not sure how the heat transference works there, but still, whatever. It's a map of second floor. Will you take it? Yes, we will. So now we've got the second floor map. And we also got a herb. Very cool. So that fills out our inventory. And we're just going to run back down and drop off the items. And I see that as a good place to end for today. Who knows, whatever mysteries we will find in the next part. Might be something magical, or imaginary, or duplicitous, or phantasmagoric. I'm just making up words now. So back down the stairs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we head into the save room again. So we're just going to dump the items. We're going to dump... Let's dump the herb. And the grenade rounds. Have a quick reload. Actually, you know, we'll take the shotgun with us. I feel a need for it. We won't take the ammo for it, just the shotgun itself. And I see that as a good place for us to end. Like I said, I have been Grandmaster Scott Hay. This has been Resident Evil. And I thank you so very, very much for watching. Das Vidania.